तो टीचिंग यू मैथ्स ऐप क्लास 10th एनसीईआरटी चैप्टर 6 ट्रायंगल। इन दिस चैप्टर प्रीवियस लेक्चर आई हैव फिनिश्ड एक्सरसाइज 6.1। नाउ यू विल सी द सिमिलरिटी ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स। सिमिलरिटी ऑफ ट्रायंगल्स, सो टू ट्रायंगल्स आर सिमिलर ओनली इफ टू कंडीशंस लाइक ए पॉलीगॉन प्रीवियस लेक्चर देयर करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स आर इक्वल एज वेल एज देयर करस्पॉन्डिंग साइड्स आर इन सेम रेशियो आर यू कैन से इट इज ए प्रपोर्शनल। इक्वी एंगुलर ट्रैंगल मीन्स इफ द टू ट्रैंगल्स आर देयर हैव देयर करस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स इक्वल देन दे आर कॉल्ड इक्वी एंगुलर ट्रैंगल्स। इन द ग्रेट मैथमेटिशियन थेल्स गिव्स द इम्पॉर्टेंट ट्रूथ that the ratio of any two corresponding sides of two equiangular definitions I have to given all the angles of first are equal to corresponding angle of others are called equiangular. So the ratio of any two sides of a two equiangular triangles is always the same. It is truth given by the Thales, and by this it is named as a base Thales theorem, or you can say basic proportionality theorem. That you know here, Thales 640 for 546 BC. So he has given a ratio of the sides of any two triangle if their angles are equal. This theorem is called the Thales theorem, and it is called BPT in the short form. So what is the BPT? If a line is drawn. Actually, in one triangle you divide in two triangles. If a line is drawn parallel to any one side of a triangle, it intersects the other two sides at two distinct points, then the other two sides divide in the same ratio. It is R proportional. That is called theorem BPT, which is known as Thales theorem. It is also known as the Thales theorem. BPT or Thales theorem, which is very important theorem of this chapter. Any triangle, here it is given 6.1 theorem, any triangle if any one side parallel to the other, any one line parallel to any other side like this, in triangle ABC I have taken L is parallel to BC, intersect AB and AC, other two side at two distinct point. D and D. Distinct means it is not passing through A because A is a common point of AB and AC. Other than A, any place you draw. Then AD upon DB must be equal to AE upon AC. It is your Thales theorem, which is called in short form BPT. What is called BPT in capital letters? Basic proportionality theorem. For this, you will draw, first of all, you take a triangle, a line, and B will draw the perpendicular from D to AC and E to EN. Dotted line DM and EN perpendicular on AC and AB, and then join DC and BE. I have joined here DC and BE. In the proof, we apply the half into BH theorem. What is the half into BH? Area of triangle is small with the area of this triangle. I am taking area BDE. Both are on the same base, one base AD and one base is BD, but both have same altitude. Like this, you are getting a triangle which is this. So altitude from here you will get at this place. Like this, BDE will get the altitude at this place N. It is the altitude of BDE which is you are seeing. This is a triangle. So area BDE is half into BD into EN. Area of AD is half into AD into EN. Apply. EN and EL cancel, half cancel. You are getting this ratio of the two triangle in the form of their parts base AD upon BD. Similarly, you take other side. Again AD with the, this triangle, which is DEC. What is the another triangle? You are getting a triangle DEC, this triangle. In this, you will get altitude again outside, obtuse triangle, so altitude will be DM. So you are getting the DM here in that half into C into DM. Numerator, base I am changing, base AE now I am taking, so half into AE into DM, अपॉन हाफ इंटू सी इंटू डी एम. सो बोथ द हाफ एंड हाफ कैंसिल ए अपॉन सी. सो यू आर गेटिंग द टू ट्रायंगल्स, टू इक्वेशंस. वन एरिया ऑफ ए डी अपॉन अगेन ए डी अपॉन, सो टू ट्रायंगल्स. नाउ यू सी व्हाट इज द रिलेशन बिटवीन दीज टू ट्रायंगल्स. वन ट्रायंगल डी ई ऑन द बेस डी, देयर इज ए टू ट्रायंगल्स ऑन द सेम बेस एंड बिटवीन द सेम लाइन, पैरेलल लाइन. दिस इज पैरेलल टू दिस, इट इज गिवन. सो वी नो इन क्लास 9 ट्रायंगल्स ऑन द सेम बेस बिटवीन सेम पैरेलल हैव इक्वल एरियाज. सो एरिया ऑफ दिस ट्रायंगल एंड दिस ट्रायंगल विल बी इक्वल बिकॉज दे लाइज ऑन डी एंड बिटवीन डी पैरेलल टू BC. So area BD is equal to area of CD. It is the third equation. Triangles on same base between same parallel have equal areas. By this we will get first equation, when equation number 1 denominator is BD and it is a DEC, both are equal. So numerators are already equal. It means LHS of the first is equal to LHS of the second. It means third one is equal to the right side, will be also equal to right side. So by first, second and third you will get AD upon BD is equal to AE upon C. Hence proved. One more theorem that is called 6.2 theorem, converse of BPT, CBPT, converse of basic proportionality theorem. You want to prove if it is given in if a line divides the two sides of a triangle proportionally, means a line L divide AB and AC in same proportion, means AD by BD equal to AE by EC, then this line is parallel to the third side. It is the converse theorem. Main theorem, line parallel given, here line is given which divide in the same ratio. Then prove that it must be parallel to third side. So I have taken L is parallel, L is not, only triangle is given, L is a intersecting AB at AC at D and E, such that what is the relation? AD by DB is equal to AE by C. It is given. You want to prove L parallel to BC. Construction. Let L is not parallel. So draw a line DF parallel. Let, because actually it is parallel, but you want to. So one more line you draw DF, which is, suppose that it is parallel to BC. So apply the BPT. Because DF is parallel to BC, so AD by DB equal to AF by FC by BPT. A line parallel to one side, divide the two sides proportionally. AD by DB is equal to AF by FC. So it is a BPT in question 1, but it is given in the question given AD by BD is also equal to AE by C. So I am writing this. Compare both, these two will be equal. AF upon FC, AE upon EC, adding one both the side. So you will get numerator LCM and taking AF plus FC. AF plus FC is giving you what is? It is the F and it is E. A, B, C and D. So it is L line. So AF plus FC equal to AC. AE plus EC is also equal to AC by FC, AC by EC. 1 upon 1 cross multiply you are getting EC is equal to FC, which is not possible. This line is not equal to this. Only possible if E and F coincide. Only possible if E and F coincide. It means if D is parallel, DF is parallel to BC by construction, then DE will be also parallel to BC. Or you can write L is parallel to BC. It is your converse or BPT. By this, now you will see in the book there is an example given, example number 1. What is the example 1 given? If a line intersect AB and AC, triangle ABC at D and E respectively, prove that AD by AB equal to AE by AC, full line, which is also called theorem. So first of all, you write the example given, triangle ABC, L intersect, AD by DB equal to AE by EC you want. L is intersecting and given L is parallel to BC. So by BPT, what will you get? AD by DB equal to AE by EC. It is a BPT, but you want AD must be safe, so write the converse of it, that's reverse order. Reciprocal of this, BD by AD is equal to AC by AE. After this, you add both the sides. What you want to save, that you write in denominator. That's why I have written. So adding one both the side, 1 plus BD by AD, LCM you take. So AD plus BD gives you AB and AE plus EC gives you AC. You are getting? So AB by AD is equal to AC by AE, you are getting. Reciprocal of it, AD by AB equal to AE by AC, hence proved. It is also, you can direct use by the theorem. At last I have written. Example number 2 is given. There is a trapezium given. Example 2, there is a trapezium ABCD given, in which AB is parallel to CD given. E and F are the two points on non-parallel sides. You want to prove A by ED is equal to BF upon FC. I have drawn this. For the proof of this, you must take a construction. What is given? ABCD trapezium, AB is parallel to CD, it is given, E and F are the point on non-parallel side, and it is also given EF is parallel to AB, this is also parallel to AB. For the proof of this, AE upon ED equal to BF upon FC, will join AC, which intersect EF at O. Now, in triangle ABC, in triangle ABC, AB is parallel to EF, it is given. AB is parallel to OF, because AB is parallel to EF. So, by BPT, AO upon OC is equal to BF upon FC, equation 1. In triangle ADC, I am taking other part, in triangle ADC, EO is parallel to CD, EO is parallel to AB and EO is parallel to CD. Because AB is parallel to CD and AB is parallel to EF, so CD also parallel to EF, it means OE is parallel to CD. Again apply BPT, AO upon OC is AE upon ED, it is equation second. Compare both, LHS of both are equal, it means RHS will be also equal. Hence proved. The question example 3 is given. A triangle is given PQR and ST is a line in which angle S is equal to angle R. Angle PST is equal to angle PRQ, it is given. You want to prove triangle is isosceles. And it is also given PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR, it is given in the question. So I have drawn the figure. In figure, this angle is given, this angle, and PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR. You want to prove it is isosceles. For this, first of all, you draw to prove, because in triangle this, PS upon SQ is equal to PT upon TR by converse of BPT. If the lines divide line in same ratio, then it must be parallel. So ST is parallel to QR. If ST is parallel, then what about this angle and this angle? Both will be equal. And this angle will be also equal to this. Pair of corresponding angle. But angle PST is already given angle PRQ. This. Here angle 1, 2, 3. If it is angle 1 is equal to angle 2 by this, and angle 1 is also equal to angle 3 in the given. So by first and second equation, PST equal to PQR, PST equal to PRQ, then these two will be equal or not. Angle Q is equal to angle R. By first and second, we are getting angle this is equal to angle this. Q is equal to R. If angle PQR is equal to PRQ, then angle PQ is equal to PR, opposite side of equal angle. Are also equal, so PQ and PR equal, so PQR is an isosceles triangle. And now, any triangle given by BPT, you can write, first of all, in this D is parallel to BC given. So by BPT, main theorem is this, AD by DB equal to AE by EC, but you have proved in example 1, AD by AB is also equal to AE by AC, you can use this for the question as a BPT, or reverse order of, reciprocal of this, BD upon AD is also equal to CE upon AE, You can also use this for this question as a BPT. Or AD by AB by AD, AB by reciprocal of the full line upon this part, upon full line upon this part, AC by AE, you can also, if it is necessary, you can use as a theorem. Or reciprocal of same thing, BD by AB and C by AC also. This part with full line, this part with full line also. BD by AB is equal to C by AC. So any place, anything, these are the forms of the BPT. So we can use in the calculation. That's all for today. In the next lecture, I will explain the exercise 6.2. Thanks.